All right, so we've dedicated this lecture to exclusively talking about the blood vessels in the thigh region because they're very complex and they involve some important anatomical structures such as the femoral triangle, the adductor canal, and we'll go through those as well. So to start us off, we'll talk about the obturator artery. So the obturator artery, everyone's favorite arterial diagram, back to the pelvis here. It's a branch off the anterior division of the internal iliac artery. So you can see that here. Here's that internal iliac. Here's the anterior division here. And then we have it indicated here in the blue arrow. Here's your obturator artery traveling in this way here. It can also arise from the external iliac or inferior epigastric artery. So if you're in the cadaver lab, just be aware of that. It exits the pelvis via the obturator foramen and then subsequently divides into an anterior and a posterior branch, so two branches. And so it's going to come out, you know, in this region here. And what's important to know is that the anterior branch, so let's start like right here. So here's our adductor brevis. Okay, so we'll say AB. Adductor brevis muscle. So that's kind of the barrier between the two branches. So you have the anterior branch that comes down here and it goes across like this, anterior to the adductor brevis muscle, and it provides branches that supply the musculature of the thigh. There's not really much else to know about that here. Then you have the posterior branch, which dives down this way and goes behind. And so we'll stop it there because it's traveling behind the muscle here. And, you know, in a dotted line here, it gives off this acetabular branch, which kind of goes up this way. And the acetabular branch is going to, you know, supply this region in the acetabulum. And then what's important about the acetabular branch is then it gives rise to that artery to the head of the femur. So, artery to the head of the femur. And that's what, in children, gives a significant amount of blood supply to the head of the femur. The main artery in this region, the femoral artery, it's a continuation of the external iliac artery beyond the inguinal ligament inferiorly. So here's your ascis here. Here's your pubic symphysis here. So we'll just say PS there. And then here's your inguinal ligament coming across here. So here's your external iliac. So again, like in the arm, in the shoulder region, you know, the axillary, then the brachial, it's the same concept. It's the same structure. It's just where you are, what region of the body you're in. And so when it gets past this inguinal ligament landmark here, and then it becomes officially the femoral artery traveling in here. And sometimes you'll hear it called the common femoral because it splits into the profunda femoral artery, or femoral profunda, as you can see here, which is a branch similar to that profunda brachii artery in the arm. And so same concept here. It splits and then it becomes here superficial femoral, which comes down here. So it's in two branches which continue on this way. So really important to know is upon entering the thigh, the femoral artery travels within the femoral triangle, and that's a region in here that we'll talk about on the next few slides. So the femoral triangle, it's a region of the proximal thigh that contains several important neurovascular structures, and these are also clinically relevant as well, so you know it's good to be aware of these. This could be a topic on an anatomy exam, also on a board exam, so definitely be aware of. So what are the borders? So superior is the inguinal ligament. So you see the inguinal ligament traveling in here. This would be your ascis out here. Pubic symphysis would be right about here. So this is your superior border right here. Lateral border is sartorius muscle. So you can see that nicely right here. This diagram really does a great job of showing you these borders. So we come down like this. And then your medial border is that adductor longus muscle. And you can see that beautifully right here. And so there's your three sides. So inguinal ligament, sartorius, and then adductor longus, all containing these important neurovascular structures. So the contents of the femoral triangle, this is a very common anatomy exam question, could also be on a board exam as well. So a common acronym to remember is NAVEL, and you know it stands for nerve, artery, vein, empty space, and lymph nodes. And remember that this is lateral to medial. Okay, so from lateral to medial you have the nerve. So here's your sartorius here, kind of get our bearings straight here. So here's our sartorius. So this is that lateral out here. Here's your inguinal ligament right here, and then it doesn't do a great job of showing up, but your adductor longus would be down in here. Here's your fascia lata peeled away here to show you this, and then your pubic symphysis would be about right here. Ascis is up here. So just to give you all your landmarks. So here's your triangle. Here's your femoral nerve, which is the first structure encountered laterally, then the femoral artery, then the femoral vein. Then there's an empty space in here, which allows for veins and lymph vessels to distend. Arteries are considered high pressure. Veins are considered high volume, so they hold more blood volume than the arteries do, actually. And so sometimes, especially in the extremities, because you're standing up, return of venous blood is against gravity. So oftentimes blood can pool in the lower extremity veins. And so there's got to be some room in here for it to distend. And same thing with lymphatics as well. You know, there's room. It's important to have room for those to distend as well. Then medial to this empty space, you have lymph nodes and lymph vessels traveling in here. So that'd be this region here. So that'd be your lymph vessels, lymph nodes. Okay. So posterior to the femoral triangle. So again, here's adductor longus, sartorius, inguinal ligament. Here's our vessels, our navel. There's our navel. And so posterior is the pectineus muscle, which as you can see right here. So that travels posterior to the femoral triangle. So anterior to the femoral triangle is the fascia lata, and we showed that here. Here, this is, it's cut away here. Otherwise, you know, in a cadaver, you'd have to cut through the fascia lata here to get to these vessels. The femoral artery, vein, and canal are enclosed in a fascial compartment, the femoral sheath. And so you can see that very nicely here, where they're, everything's kind of encased in its own little fascial compartment. And that, this diagram does a really great job of showing that. The great saphenous vein, which is shown right here, coming up along the superficial aspect of the lower extremity, similar to the basilic vein in the upper extremity. Superficial vein going along the entire lower extremity comes up here, and it drains into the femoral vein within the femoral triangle. And this is an important fact to know, often can be tested. So the femoral pulse, very clinically relevant. Here's your pubic symphysis down here. Here's your asis up here, inguinal ligament. So you're going to go halfway between the pubic symphysis and the asis. Because remember, you know, this superficially, when you're in the clinic or the hospital, you're not going to be able to see where this is. So you can palpate these structures. You can go halfway in between right here. And then you want to palpate just before it travels past the apex of the femoral triangle. So we'll draw our borders in here. Here's your apex here. So you want to palpate right about here. So just before it goes past the apex. So, you know, in this region right in here, about halfway between the asis and the pubic symphysis, that's where you're going to palpate your femoral pulse. And that's important if, you know, it's a way to check for a pulse. It's also important because, you know, if you're a cardiologist, say, the femoral artery can be cannulated just inferior to this midpoint of the inguinal ligament. And the reason for that is, you know, for heart catheterization. So if you're doing an angioplasty or if you're doing a cardiac catheterization to kind of shoot some x-ray dye in and get a look at the coronary vessels, the catheter is actually threaded in through the femoral artery because of this access here of the femoral triangle. Is you can easily access this and thread the catheter up through the iliac, up through the aorta, and then up into the heart. And so you can shoot some x-ray dye in and get a good picture of the heart. You can do angioplasty if there's blockages. The other way is also if you're in the ICU, it's a critically ill patient, you want to get an arterial blood gas or an ABG. You can stick a needle in this area and draw out arterial blood. So in this proximal portion of the femoral artery, so again, this is lateral, this is medial. In this proximal portion, there's a lot of different arteries here, and these are good to find in the cadaver lab. And we're just going to briefly talk about these here. These aren't super high yield for a board exam, but definitely an anatomy exam, you would want to be aware of these. So first, superficial epigastric. This artery branches just below the inguinal ligament, so the inguinal ligament's going to be in here. As you can see here very nicely, it just branches up here. Travels very superficial through the subcutaneous tissue, and it shows you that here because here's the skin just peeled away, and then here's the sub-Q tissue. Up the anterior abdominal wall, so even though it comes off in the lower extremity, it's going to go up through the anterior abdominal wall and then up towards this umbilicus. So that's important. So just distal to the inguinal ligament, ascends up subcutaneously in the abdominal wall near the umbilicus. And then here's some other branches, and this diagram really does an awesome job of showing you all these branches. It's really, really a great one. So superficial circumflex iliac artery. So here's the first one right here. So we'll label this one. Here's one. And you can see this very nicely where it's branching off right here, just proximal. You can see all these branches. And it branches parallel to the inguinal ligament. So you can see here's the inguinal ligament. Here's this superficial iliac circumflex traveling out laterally here. And it travels parallel with the ligament, and then it pierces the fascia lata to reach as far right or far lateral as the iliac crest, which would be out this way. So it keeps going out this way. It's going to pierce that fascia lata. Superficial external pudendal. So that's these guys right here. So here you go right there. This is coming off right here, and you can see it traveling more medially this way. And it courses medially over to cross over the spermatic cord, and this diagram really does an awesome job. So here's the spermatic cord right here. Here's the artery traveling off the medial proximal aspect of the femoral artery, and it comes off and it goes right over that spermatic cord and keeps on going. And then, you know, in the case of a female, this would be the round ligaments. And then it goes on to, after crossing over the ligament, is it supplies the skin on the lower abdomen and the genital area. So that would be right in here. And then the third branch we're going to talk about here is the deep external pudendal, which is this guy right here. Again, comes off a little more distal than these branches up here. And it courses medially across the pectineus. Here's the pectineus muscle. So it's traveling right here across this pectineus. And the adductor and longus muscle, so it travels across this muscle as well. And then it supplies the skin and the perineum and the genital region. And that makes sense. It travels into this area, into the genital and perineal regions. Just makes sense. It's coursing towards that. So the profunda femoris artery, or femoral profunda as it's labeled here in this diagram, shown right here, is a branch off the femoral artery. It's also known as the deep femoral artery. And it arises in the femoral triangle. So your femoral triangle, so here would be kind of your inguinal ligament, be in this region right here. So just right in here in the femoral triangle. It ascends in the thigh between the adductor longus and the pectineus, adductor brevis, and adductor magnus muscles. So this can kind of help you if you're trying to look for it in a cadaver. It travels closer to the femur than the femoral artery, and you can see that right here. So here's your superficial femoral, and then here's your profunda femoris artery, traveling right here, and then here's your femur. So that's an important spatial relationship to be aware of. It's also deeper in the thigh than the superficial femoral, hence the name superficial femoral. And then it gives off the medial and lateral circumflex femoral arteries. So these are those arteries you talked about in the hip lecture. They provide a lot of blood supply here to the hip joint and the proximal femur here. So here they're labeled external circumflex, internal circumflex, same thing, medial and lateral circumflex femoral arteries, and those come off the profunda femoris artery. The profunda femoris also gives off three perforating arteries, and they're actually named. So here's the first perforating, here's the second perforating, third perforating right here. And they're named because they all perforate the tendon of the adductor magnus muscle to reach the posterior thigh. Remember that adductor magnus is coming in here like this, and it kind of fans out like this. So all these are perforating that tendon, and then they go on to supply the thigh muscles, and they all form an anastomosis with each other to help with collateral circulation. So the first perforating artery is shown right here. First perforating artery, it turns posteriorly between the pectineus and adductor brevis muscles, and then it goes on to pierce that adductor magnus muscle. Second perforating, which is shown right here, this guy right here, as you can see, it pierces the tendons of the adductor brevis and magnus muscles, and then it splits into an ascending and a descending. So here's your ascending right here, here's your descending right here. And it also gives off a branch that is the nutrient artery of the femur, so it provides blood supply directly to the femur bone. Then you have the third perforating right here, and you can see that coming off right here. And this branches off below the adductor brevis muscle, right before it pierces the adductor magnus muscle. So all these landmarks where these muscles are, this, you know, it's not high yield for a board exam, but, you know, if you're taking an anatomy exam, you know, you may get asked this. It's probably also more, it's more so helpful for when you're going into the cadaver lab and you're trying to find these arteries. These can be good landmarks because, as you well know at this point, there's no labels in the body, so any landmark you can get is really helpful. And then what's important to know is that the profunda femoris artery terminates as the fourth perforating artery. So here it is coming off, giving off all these first, second, third perforating arteries, and then down here it terminates as the fourth. So the medial circumflex femoral artery in this diagram is labeled internal circumflex. It arises from the profunda femoris, sometimes the femoral artery in the femoral triangle. So, you know, if you see that in a cadaver, don't be surprised. It travels between the pectineus and iliopsoas muscles. Remember iliopsoas, you have your iliac is here, psoas coming in here, and they kind of form a common muscle that comes down here and forms this tendon that inserts onto the lesser trochanter. And then it turns posteriorly, the artery turns posteriorly to enter the gluteal region between the adductor magnus and quadratus femoris muscles in here. And if you remember, this is the major blood supply to the hip region. So it gives off the following branches, and you can see that right here. So here it's coming in, and it gives off an acetabular branch, which goes up in this region here. And this provides the majority of the blood supply to the femoral head and the hip joint. It gives an ascending branch, which forms an anastomosis with the superior inferior gluteal arteries, so coming up this way. Then it gives a transverse branch, which kind of comes out this way and joins the cruciate anastomosis, which is an anastomosis network here in the hip, gluteal, proximal thigh region that helps provide collateral circulation. And we'll talk about that in a few slides here. The lateral circumflex femoral, in this diagram, it's labeled at the external circumflex, again, rises from the profunda femoris in the femoral triangle. Sometimes it arises from the femoral artery, travels laterally, and you can see that right here. Here's the medial going deep this way. Here's the lateral coming out this way. Travels deep to sartorius and rectus femoris muscles. That makes sense. These muscles are coming in this way right here. Divides into three branches. It has an ascending branch, which actually you can see right here. So here's the ascending branch wrapping around. And this forms part of that vascular circle with the medial circumflex femoral that goes around the femoral neck and also forms an anastomosis with the superior gluteal artery. You have a transverse branch, which kind of goes out this way laterally, and that contributes to the cruciate anastomosis. And then you have a descending branch, which comes down this way, and that forms an anastomosis with branches of the popliteal artery at the knee. So it's going to actually come all the way down here because the popliteal artery is right here. So the adductor canal, this is an important anatomical structure, kind of like the femoral triangle that houses a lot of important neurovascular structures. So it's an aponeurotic tunnel, so it's formed from an aponeurosis in the thigh and extends from the apex of the femoral triangle. So let's draw our femoral triangle. So here's our sartorius, and it's cut away here. Here's the distal portion of sartorius here. So here's, these are both the sartorius here. So this would be our femoral triangle here. Here's our adductor longus here. Forms our medial border here, and then their inguinal ligament. So here's our femoral triangle here. And so it extends from this apex here. So here's the apex of the triangle. So here's would be our initial opening. And then it extends from that apex of the femoral triangle to the adductor hiatus, which you can see right here. So here's the hiatus right here. And that's within the distal portion of the adductor magnus muscle tendon. And so the adductor canal, it courses between the anterior and medial compartments of the thigh. So here's the anterior compartment here. Here's the medial compartment over here. So it's kind of like a bordering region between the two compartments. And then the aponeurosis is an extension from the vastus medialis muscle. So here's your vastus medialis muscle right here. Because remember, here's your rectus femoris here. Here's vastus lateralis here. And then here's vastus medialis here. And so, you know, it's all part of your quadriceps muscle, which all converge on your quadriceps tendon here. So the aponeurosis extends out from this muscle like this to encase these vessels as they travel through this part just before they reach the distal portion of the adductor magnus muscle. So this is really your tunnel in here, or canal. So the boundaries. So again, we'll draw our femoral triangle first. So this is your femoral triangle first, not the adductor canal. Inguinal ligament here. Here's your sartorius here. Here's your sartorius down here, lateral, medial. So here's your inguinal ligament, sartorius down here, adductor longus this way. So here's your femoral triangle here. Then here's your apex right here, which forms the beginning of the adductor canal. And then here's the adductor hiatus right here. So now, where are the borders? So sartorius. So here's a sartorius muscle. Sartorius muscle is going to come down like this. Remember, it's that long, kind of strappy muscle like this. This is your lateral border, okay? And then your medial border is adductor longus, which is here, so AL. And then adductor magnus, which is down here, so AM. Then vastus medialis, which is providing that aponeurosis, which is just as we kind of drew over it here. We'll show it right here. This is your medial border, and it extends all the way up here. So the contents, they all enter the canal via the superior foramen at the apex of the femoral triangle. So again, this is lateral, this is medial. Here's your inguinal ligament, sartorius down here, femoral triangle is right here. So here's the triangle. So right here at the apex, they all enter there. And then the femoral artery and the femoral vein are traveling in here. So you can see that very nicely here. Here's that profunda right here. So the profunda does not travel. The profunda goes deep into the thigh. The superficial femoral travels within the canal with the femoral vein. And the femoral vein is you know, coming back this way because it's draining the lower extremity. So the femoral veins, even though they're both traveling, the blood's traveling in opposite directions, kind of like cars going two different ways on a road. Then you also have the saphenous nerve, which is a branch off the femoral nerve. So here's the saphenous nerve here. So femoral nerve kind of comes out here and it sprays out like this. And one of the branches is the saphenous nerve, which then travels through the canal, as you can see here. So here's the saphenous nerve. Another important content here is the descending genicular artery. And here it's labeled the highest genicular, same thing. It branches off the femoral artery within the canal. And so you can see that here. Here's the femoral artery here. It branches right here. And then it exits with the saphenous nerve. So here's that saphenous nerve. And here you can see the saphenous nerve traveling with this descending genicular artery. Then the artery travels down this way, and it, after exiting the canal, it pierces the septum between the anterior and medial compartments, and then it finally divides into two branches. So here's an articular branch, which goes down to form this anastomosis around the knee, and then it has a saphenous branch, which travels more superficially here with the saphenous nerve, because the saphenous nerve becomes a more superficial nerve around the knee joint and then down into the leg, and it supplies the medial aspect of the cutaneous region around the knee. The femoral artery and vein, they exit the canal via the inferior foramen, which is called the adductor hiatus, which is in that adductor magnus muscle tendon. And it's, you know, right where the tendon is inserting onto the femur. So the cruciate anastomosis is something we've been referring to in the last few slides. It's an anastomosis network in the superior thigh region and the posterior aspect near the hip joint and the gluteal region. And it enables blood to reach the popliteal artery, which is at the in the knee region, if the external iliac and or the femoral arteries were to become obstructed. So here, here. So if you have an obstruction here, you know, this is right before all the blood supply to the lower extremity. So you have a huge problem because you could have an ischemic lower extremity, which is not good. So this anastomosis allows blood supply to bypass a blockage and then continue on to the popliteal, which would enable it even to get into the more distal aspect of the lower extremity. It has four main contributing arteries: the inferior gluteal artery, the lateral circumflex femoral artery, the medial circumflex femoral artery, which are both branches off of this femoral profunda, if you remember, lateral circumflex, medial circumflex, and then that first perforating artery as well. And then inferior gluteal would be, you know, traveling in this gluteal region, comes out greater sciatic foramen, then it comes out and descends down this way. So this artery comes down, so this would be inferior glute, and then it comes down this way, and then you have these two circumflex arteries contributing in like this. So here's lateral circumflex, here's medial circumflex, and then you'd have this first perforating branch coming up like this. So it has a branch coming up like this. So we blow this up here. It forms, as you can kind of see here, and even better here, is it forms a cross. So this would be a posterior view, cross-like structure. And then here's that medial circumflex feeding it, lateral circumflex, inferior gluteal coming from superior, and then first perforating coming up from inferior. So the flow of blood here, so let's say you had a blockage right here, and you can't have it. So you have inferior gluteal, which comes off the anterior division of the internal iliac. So you have this anterior division, and then inferior gluteal emerges out like this, comes down like this. So this would be your inferior gluteal. Then that goes into the perforating branch. So it inferior gluteal, so then it comes into this cruciate anastomosis. So it's going to come down like this. Then it goes into the perforating branch. So it goes into the perforating branch like this. And then the perforating branch feeds into the lateral circumflex, which then, as you can see here, so here's that descending branch. So external circumflex, same thing as lateral. So it's fed down into here, goes through the first perforating, and then into the lateral circumflex. And then the lateral circumflex has this descending branch, which then comes down like this, right? And so it comes down this descending branch of the lateral circumflex. And then that gives off an artery down here in the knee region called the superior lateral genicular artery. So SLG, which would be right here. So this descending branch, and it comes off of this descending branch, and then that would go into the popliteal, which is the popliteal is the continuation of the superficial femoral artery in the knee region. So just to review one more time, so you have a blockage here, you're going to need blood to get down here. So the blood's going to come down this anterior division of the internal iliac, come down the inferior gluteal, come into the cruciate anastomosis, which is going to be right around here. It's going to come in here, go to the first perforating branch of the profunda femoris, and make its way into the lateral circumflex, and then via the lateral circumflex, going to go down this descending branch, and then make its way into the superior lateral genicular artery, which then joins with the popliteal artery down here. Essentially, big arrow going down like this to here. So the femoral vein is formed from the popliteal vein. So here's the knee region right about here. Here's your popliteal right here. And then these are veins that are in the lower extremity that are going to join here, draining the lower extremity, and then come up in here to form the popliteal, specifically the peroneal and the tibial veins coming in this way. Then the popliteal vein becomes the femoral vein at that adductor hiatus, so that beginning of the adductor canal, or the distal opening of the adductor canal. Remember, the proximal opening is at the apex of the femoral triangle. So if you remember down here, here's the apex right here of the canal. The canal then goes down here like this, and then here's the hiatus. Here's your femoral vein, which is going to be traveling through here. So the popliteal comes up like this. And then past this hiatus, it becomes femoral vein. Then it becomes external iliac vein at the border of the inguinal ligament. So here, and then once it goes beyond here, it's external iliac. Within the femoral triangle, the great saphenous vein, as you can see here, and the deep vein of the thigh drain into the femoral vein. So both these veins join the femoral vein at this portion right here. And that concludes our discussion of the blood vessels in the thigh region. The next lecture is going to be our last lecture about the thigh region, where we'll talk about the nerves and the relevant clinical pearls.